Charles Rocket and Gail Matthius.
Good evening, I'm Charles Rocket. Here now the news, our top story. For the first time in his life, Frank Sinatra had a drink today with a man who does not have a nickname. Make a note of it. Upon his arrival in Cebu City, Philippines, the Pope said, and I'm quoting now, "The selfish pursuit of sexual pleasure and the fear of permanent commitment are destructive forces and as such should be restricted to the state of California." Gail.
The United States Postal Service got approval to raise the price of a stamp to 18 cents. The additional revenue will go toward improving their service. That means that now you'll get the wrong mail a day earlier. Okay. The drought continues in the Northeast. To make sure that all New Yorkers can serve water, Mayor Koch announced that the city is piping in all its water from Three Mile Island. In New Jersey, reservoir levels are so low that a woman in Newark turned on her sink and out popped Jimmy Hoffa's pinky ring. It's true.
Would you believe that this is a photo of a congressman's wife? Well, it is. And this is how she'll look in next month's Playboy. Her name, Rita Jenrette. Her husband, John Jenrette, an abs camp victim. As you can see, apparently he needed the money for a breast lift. Rita also revealed that she and her husband once made love on the steps of the Capitol building. And as many Washington insiders know, this is just the tip of the iceberg. Yes, Margaret Trudeau was frequently seen late at night in the skimpy slithering up to the Washington Monument. That's not all. Yes, and there was Truman Capote, who once spent the night in the tomb of the unknown soldier. Old Truman, come on now, huh? Well, the pressure of Washington, I guess, leads to strange behavior. In Las Vegas, fire marshals have asked the city's hotels to increase their fire safety standards. Well, Caesar's Palace has come up with the quickest way to evacuate their guests. What do they do? Hey, I'll answer that for you. They have installed smoke alarms that play a recording of Eddie Fisher singing, "Oh, My Papa." Gail.
The State Department announced that it's becoming more and more alarmed as Cuba continues to ship arms and weapons to the communist guerrillas in El Salvador. The chances of American intervention are growing. Bob Hope is already practicing how to say Merry Christmas in Spanish. Heavy fighting in El Salvador. Many casualties resulted when a guerrilla bugle boy panicked. Instead of sounding retreat, he played the best of Herb Alpert.
The latest trend in music. No, not Herb Alpert. It's coming from, of all places, Italy. Inspired by Jamaican rock, the new sound is called ragu music. Incidentally, it is performed by an Italian religious group called the Pastafarians. And now, Budget Director David A. Stockman with a message for the nation's nearly needy. Mr. Stockman.
This week, a great many of you found out that you are not truly needy, but only nearly needy. In other words, you won't be getting food stamps anymore. But I've come up with a new way you can earn back those food stamps and at the same time help fight crime. We call it Catch a Crook, Eat a Meal program. How does it work? It's simple. If you qualify as a nearly needy person, you can hunt down wanted criminals and turn them in for food stamps. Can you catch a mugger? If you can, we'll give you enough food stamps for a hearty breakfast of ham and eggs and all the coffee you can drink. Still hungry? Bring us an armed robber and we'll feed you for a week. And that's not all. Gun down a suspected murderer, and we'll give you $10,000 cash tomorrow, and you can forget about food stamps. If you only wound the suspect and he gets away, you get nothing. For further details, this pamphlet, Catch a Crook, Eat a Meal, is available at your post office, along with a list of wanted criminals and local gun shops. Remember, we'll double your stamps if you bring your suspect in alive.
Thank you, Mr. Stockman. Well, this week, Mr. Reagan announced other budget cuts, which included a 50% reduction in funding to the theater arts. When asked whether this would severely hamper the education of future performers, Mr. Reagan replied, and I'm quoting now, "Hey, I made it without learning how to act." in all, 83 big programs were whittled down to the bone, totaling over $41.4 billion in cuts. Food stamps, Medicaid, subsidized housing, child nutrition, student aid, mass transit cuts, big cuts, cuts that affect all of us. Listen here, Ronnie, baby. If you want to save money, why don't you have Nancy shop at Sears? Challenger Wendell, which will be seen later live on this evening's program. For Gail Matthius and the entire weekend update team, I'm Charles Rocker. Good night and watch out.